So in the meristematic zone, it is few millimeter in length and lies partially covered with the root cap, and cells of this zone divide actively and add new cells to the root and to the root cap. Now the next zone is the elongation zone. Now what is elongation? We all have learned already that cells after division undergoes growth. So this is the zone where elongation or growth of the cells is going on. So it lies just behind the meristematic zone and is 4 to 8 millimeter long, and the cells of this region are newly formed but lost the property of division because division of labor or differentiation, because now they will become a part of different portion of the root. They elongate rapidly and brings about increase in the length of the root. These also possess the power of absorption of water, minerals, salts from the soil. The fourth zone is the zone of the root hair. It lies above the zone of elongation and bears a cluster of root hairs. Remember, single cell root hair. They develop from epiblema. Epiblema is the word used for epidermis in the case of roots, and increase the surface area for more absorption. As the root increases in length, root hairs in the older portion die, so they become brown, shriveled, and then they are shed. However, new root hairs grow in the younger portion of the zone. Remember, today if the zone is in the root hair zone, it will next day or some other day it will go into the next zone, and whatever is in the elongation zone will shift to the root hair zone, and whatever is in the meristematic zone will divide to add more cells to elongation zone. So this growth is always going on. Older root hairs are gone, new one will come because new portion has now entered into the root hair zone. Now the last portion of this root parts of the root is the maturation zone. It forms the major part of the root and no cellular changes occur in this region. And remember, major part because supportive in nature. Lateral roots develop from this zone. So whenever growth second whenever the branches develop in root, branches do not develop from root cap or from meristematic or elongation or root hair. The branches develop from maturation zone and develop from which portion? Pericycle, which we will cover in sixth chapter. That's why, because it is inside, so this development is called as endogenous type of growth. The outermost layer of this zone has thick wall which do not allow the water absorption and gives mechanical support. So main function of the maturation zone is to provide mechanical support to the whole stem, because it's a huge plant and the root has to support the whole body. That's why maturation zone is supportive in nature. Now the next thing is to study the root system. So types of root system, functions of root system, modification, and then this would be over. So the root system is, there are two types of root system in plants: tap root system and the adventitious root system. Tap root system develops from the radicles. I have already told you this. The tap root is the root which develops from the seed, and which part of the seed? Radical portion of the embryo. Radical portion of the embryo. It develops from radical of the embryo of a seed. The first root elongates and then it is called as the primary root. If it persists throughout, it is called as the tap root. The reason is, in the case of monocots, the primary root will not persist. That's why we always learned till ninth class that there is adventitious roots or fibrous roots in monocots and tap root in the dicot. But the reality is, tap root or primary root is also present in the monocots, but it does not stay for long time. That's why it is replaced by fibrous root. It produces the lateral roots called as the secondary roots. They further branch to produce tertiary roots, and finally there will be rootlets. The tap root along with its branches form tap root system, and this root system is of two types. Now let's understand this. If a root goes deep inside and then start developing branches like this, So the shape of the root appears to be like a cone and it has gone deep inside. The second possibility is the taproot does not grow that deep inside and start developing long branches like this. So the shape appears to be a dome shape. So now these roots don't go deep inside but cover a great surface area. So now two types of the root system are deep feeder or racemose type. And this is called a surface feeder or the cymose type. Such plants are easily uprooted, such trees will be easily uprooted during the dust storms and all, but these will not be uprooted in this, sorry, this will not be uprooted easily, these will be uprooted easily because they do not go deep inside. So anchorage is poor in this case, anchorage is better in this case. Now let's quickly go through it. Deep feeder root system is the taproot of the many perennial plants or trees which penetrate deep inside the soil and is also called as racemose type of taproot system. Surface feeder root system, the taproot of some annual plants does not penetrate deep inside and spread to the greater extent. Mostly horizontally, it remains near to the soil, and these are called as cymose type of taproot system. Now, the second root system possible is the adventitious root system. The roots that develop from any other part but not from radical. So remember, taproot system develops from radical and adventitious root develop from any other portion but not the radical and are called as adventitious. The word adventitious in Latin language means extraordinary. So you can learn like this. Taproots are the ordinary roots. They develop from the radical of the embryo of a seed, and adventitious roots are extraordinary roots, so they do not develop from radical, they develop from some other portion but not from radical. A mass of adventitious roots along with its branches constitute the adventitious root system. Plants with the adventitious roots also develop primary root from radical, but it is short-lived and does not produce taproot. So please remember, monocots also in the beginning have a primary root, but that does not live for long time because even monocots have a radical inside their embryo. That's why they also develop a primary root, but it does not live long to be called as a taproot. These roots may develop from the nodes or internodes. So adventitious roots